四号华埠点解一夜之间成为咗派对地点？面对繁嚣同埋热闹，华埠商户同住客同埋嗰啲冇被邀请嘅游人，却只系能够喺围栏外观睇。One night in Chinatown 留低好多欢颜，不过对于派对地点附近嘅商户，留低更多嘅可能系埋怨。One night in Chinatown 留低几许争议同思量。盗版街是极具代表性的商业街，之前 KQED 揀在这里为美国公共电视台举办的年度私人聚会，与会者一边欣赏着浓浓中国风的街景，一边享受着爵士乐西式快餐，并且封锁街道，引起商户不满。这样究竟是间接宣传华埠，定是消遣中国文化呢？华人历史学会执行主任李润平对于商家遇到的问题表示遗憾。
But I think that the event is important for Chinatown, because while Chinatown is a tourist attraction, we earn a lot of money from tourists. Events like this, I think, feature Chinatown in a different way. People from media stations all over the country, and so they wanted to come to Chinatown to see the neighborhood in a different way. That we also have a deep history. So when those people go back to their media stations, and when issues come up concerning the Chinese, they have a deeper understanding of the Chinese community.
然而，除了个别一两户拒绝表态之外，盗版街800号街区绝大多数的商户都有不同程度的不满。他们指没有收到任何的通知，个别有收到的亦都认为通知太过含糊，已经不记得了。此外，流动餐车首尾相连，挡住整条街的店门，街道两旁设有围栏，令到民众冇办法穿过马路进入商店。多个商家都表示，通常佢哋会7点、8点钟先至闩门，但系当日必须要提早收档。
会影响我哋嘅生意啦 ，and then 就少咗生意咯。譬如好似今日冇博节，但系咁今日嘅生意其实会好过嗰日。
那时候呢，摆街的时候呢，他没有跟我们讲得很清楚，他到底是要怎么做。后来他们就把厕所放在我对面，我就觉得非常不方便。还有他们那个 food truck 都是他们自己叫人家拿来的，就是说对我们 Chinatown 这些商户都没有什么好处，你知道吗？因为你至少如果来 Chinatown， 你要吃中国人的餐嘛，给我们那个华埠带一点生气，对不对？而且他们呢，很早就开始在这里 set up， 那 set up 以后弄得这里很吵，然后都没有客人过来，整个街都封掉了。我觉得应该要赔偿的啦，对我们这些商户，他们还在有那个爵士乐，还有那个非常吵哎，他们在我们前面放一个喇叭。
但你琴日咁样，我哋唐人坊大把餐馆佢用得着啫，点解唔用得豪华房啲餐馆咧？你走五六步，走成六七步 food truck 入嚟，连酒水车都走埋嚟，咁我哋唐人坊咪一滴都揾唔到滴水不？
積極組織該聚會的商家雷碧珍就有不同的看法。
I wanted to bring some much needed publicity to Chinatown. We had 800 people who really, really enjoyed themselves. They would have never come to Chinatown had it not been for this party. And it's unfortunate that there are a few people who always complain.
記者就對這宗封街派對事件走訪了三藩市交通局，發言人 Paul Rose 指出，在同一個活動預案之前，他们对盗版街的商户进行了一一走访和面谈。
Well, what we know about this event is that it was planned months ahead of time. And we know that flyers were distributed in English and in Chinese to the community. The company also went out to each of the merchants in the area to tell them about this event and that it was upcoming. We also had a hearing to discuss that the event was coming up and the feedback that we got from the community was that this was something that they appreciated, the fact that we were coming to them early.
That's what they lie, you know, they all the block the whole road, we have no business at all, none.
肯定没有收到那个通知或什么其他的，影响很大，整天都做不到生意。
他们没有给过张纸我的，因为我记得呢，他跟我讲东西啊，讲那些 Channel 9那些东西啊，想说 improve Chinatown 啊。
他们从来没问过我们，因为他没有把那个真实的情况告诉我们嘛，对不对？他等到他全部 set up 我们一下，哎呀，不对啊，你怎么可以这样？
茶馆梁太更加抗议话，当日佢先生出殡，假如事前有通知封街，佢唔可能唔知道。而当局批准喺当日正午至到午夜可以封街，而且一切都有按照程序办理申请。佢仲喺交通局网站上公示为筹款活动。但系举办方 KQED 公共电视台传播主任 Delinda Marker 就表示，呢个系美国公共电视台嘅年度私人聚会，今年设喺三藩市举办，唔涉及任何筹款或者系牟利行为，亦都冇俾任何商家经济补偿。至于点解出现唔一致，双方都未俾出确实嘅答复。
有人嚟过，但系只系讲话有关呢个 KQED 呢个 fundraising 嘅事情。但佢走過只有一分鐘都冇走，咁講話即係叫我哋支持佢呢個活動。
好在活動喺夜晚九點半鐘之前已經完全清場，冇持續擾民。
Well, the event itself was celebrating independent film. As the host station, we really wanted to create an event to show people San Francisco, and we thought Chinatown's one of the most beautiful parts of San Francisco. So we really looked to hold an event out in the community, and we felt Chinatown would be the perfect place.
KQED 为此亦都在两个月之前一一通知商户，并且发放通知单，仲指出不会影响餐馆的生意。
将那盏咪表挂了牌呢，只是写住这个 KQED events， 不以为你打车位啫。因为原来你完全都没有讲及过封街。
It was a private event, so it was only for people attending the conference and some select filmmakers. So no one walking on the streets could attend the event or purchase food from the food trucks. We really wanted to celebrate diverse voices, multicultural stories and experiences. So we wanted to not just show Chinatown, but show other cultures as well. So that's why we had a variety of trucks with both Chinese food, American food, Mexican food, to really spotlight all the offerings of the community.
既然你是用不着我们唐人埠的餐馆，你来唐人埠做什么？对不对？你現在找我們台台服做個背景，你走去找你那些什麼了。
而記者由 KQED 拎到的是一份封街聽證會的通知單，並沒有寫出具體的活動內容和封街範圍。即使商戶有收到，亦都已經是兩個月之前，並且可能因為措辭含糊，以為事不關己而忽略。此外，通告的內容和事實有諸多不符。他提及華人歷史學會會提供移動陳列展示華埠的歷史文化。
We didn't provide a mobile display down at the event because the street was way too narrow.
通知單上所列舉的市長李孟賢和市參事邱順福亦都並沒有出席活動。代表華埠的市參事邱順福事後亦都對事件作出了回應。
Clearly there was a breakdown here. In the future, if there are events like this that could bring economic activity to Chinatown, we need to make sure that the events work for the community, are Chinatown merchants and residents, that they are respectful to the neighborhood and the community.
封街本身在華埠亦都並不受歡迎，
因為我們每一年啊，整條Grand街已經承受緊六日傳統性的節日，根本上你擺街會對我們商會絕對沒有益處的。
歐氏夫婦更加說，街區商鋪會聯名上書給市參事和市府，要求當局重視這類型的問題。大型户外私人派对占用华埠举行并不常见，咁匆匆的华埠一夜，对宣传华埠或者是帮助树立华埠正面形象能够有几多的功效呢，就见仁见智了。不过华埠商户似乎更加在意在举办类似活动之前怎样能够准确落实沟通，以及采取怎样的方式才能够确保尊重社区意愿，平衡各方面利益。这些都值得日后有意举办同类型活动的人士深思。